Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dutch Sheet Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. And this here is my Beta FV X-Night. Now, the X-Night is actually a ready-to-fly quadcopter. However, I'm building it myself from the frame and the motors. And I'm designing part of the canopy myself. And okay, so this video here is going to be an introduction basically to this build. I'm going to tell you what parts I'm going to be using, why, and I have actually designed part of this canopy, as I said. So I'll tell you why and how I did that. And one of the parts for this build took quite a bit of searching. So this video should be interesting to you if you are thinking about building a 4-inch or maybe you are in the process. Let's get into it. Alrighty. I'm gonna move quickly here, so pay attention. Most of the things I'll show you here are basically the same parts as the X-Night ready to fly you can buy. Especially, of course, the frame. I already did a review of this frame and I'll have a link up there to my review of this X-Night frame. It is available as a 4-inch and a 5-inch frame, and in my case I have the 4-inch version. Yeah, so I've already gone ahead and mounted the motors. I just couldn't help myself. Also, I wanted to figure out how I wanted the wiring of the motors to run. As you can hopefully see, I'm running the motor wires on the side of the arms. And that's not something I usually do, but there are two reasons for this. I didn't want the motor wires to run over this screw, and there are four of those, of course, one on each corner. So this is a metal screw, and yeah, there's a possibility of it damaging the motor wire, so I didn't want that. Also, this skirt at the side of the flight controller, as you'll see in a minute, I would have had to make cutouts or indents for the motor wires had the motor wires ran over the arms. This way, it's a lot neater a setup. So those are the two reasons, and well, this should work out pretty well, I think. Also, of course, if I bend a propeller, the propeller won't strike the motor wires. Okay, so these motors are Beta FV motors, and these are also the same motors as Beta FV uses on their X-Night ready-to-fly quadcopter. At least on their 4-inch version of the X-Night. I don't think there's a 5-inch, maybe there will be. These are 1505 motors, 3600 kV. And that will make this a 4S quadcopter, 4-inch, obviously. Yeah, so again, same motors, and we'll just see how those work out. Basically, I've had Beta FV do the engineering for me in this case. However, my X-Night will be a little lighter than theirs. Especially because my canopy is smaller and the camera I'm using is smaller, and my FV antenna as well. Those are actually the major changes from the ready-to-fly version. So, then there's this canopy ring, right? So I'm not using the Beta FV canopy. Basically, mostly because I'm using a nano-size camera. This is the Runcam Racer Nano. I'm not completely sure what Beta FV uses. Caddx? Maybe? Not a bad camera, but this one is a lighter, especially. Yeah, so that's why I'm using a different canopy. This canopy is simply smaller and lighter. And also, this way I have a quadcopter that's, well, unique to me, right? Okay, so let me actually remove this canopy so we can have a look at the inners of this quadcopter. Hachiki day. So this top part, the part that houses the camera basically, I took that off of Thingiverse. It's designed by Le Drone Club, and I'll have a link to this canopy in the description of this video. And as you can tell, this skirt or shroud protects my 401 ESC and flight controller. And a lot of these toothpick ultralight quadcopters have their electronics out in the open, and I definitely do not like that. Yeah, I don't like the looks of it, and I want my electronics to be protected somewhat. So, what you see here is a 4-in-1 ESC, and that's the same board Beta FFV uses on their X-Night. It is a 20 amp, so 4 times 20 amp 4-in-1 ESC and an F4 flight controller. Right, so yeah, I designed actually this shroud. And it fits perfectly to, well, a lot of these kinds of canopies. This is not the only canopy of its kind. Some are a little more open, and yeah, there are a lot of options on the Thingiverse, and I've obviously printed this one myself, and this shroud, this well, hoop, a protective ring, I designed myself, and I'll have a link to this design in the description of this video as well. Yeah, so it does have a couple of cutouts for the wiring, for the power cables over here, and also a cutout over here for the USB connector. You do want to access for to your USB connector, obviously, to configure the board. Yeah, so what I will have to probably do is solder up the motor wires from the bottom. Yeah, that won't be too much of a problem. I will have to simply remove this shroud to gain access, probably, maybe not even that, but yeah. So as you can tell, the 4-in-1 ESC fits perfectly in this shroud. Cool stuff. Yeah, and I'll have more than enough room for a receiver and a VTX in this canopy. So again, I already have the camera in the canopy. This is a Runcam Razer version 1, by the way. I simply had that in the parts bin, and it's a great camera, so why not use that? And so this canopy is by Le Drone Club, right? And their specifications, their design page didn't state which FV antenna they were using. And yeah, this canopy has this hoop, this mount for your antenna, and none of the antenna I had fit this ring, this canopy. So that was a bit of a bummer. I did me some looking around, and I basically just took a gamble on this True RC antenna, and it fits perfectly. So if you'd wanna use this canopy by the Drone Club, this FFV antenna will fit. And True RC has a great reputation, an excellent reputation in FFV antenna land. So it's not a bad choice in any way, this antenna. And the last thing about this 4-in-1 20 amp ESC flight controller from Beta FFV, this is not the first time I'm using it. I actually recently used it in this DeadGet 3-inch quadcopter. And perfect. Yeah, in this configuration it's a bit overkill, overpowered. This 3-inch quadcopter definitely doesn't pull 20 amps, but it's what was easy to work on. And again, it performs, especially the 4-in-1 ESC performs admirably, basically without fault. The throttle response is very precise and consistent over all four ESCs. Then the VTX I'll be using for this build is a Runcam TX100, which is also the same one I'm using in this 3-inch build. Admirably works like a charm. Yes, the maximum output is only 100 milliwatt, but I don't really need more. And with a good antenna, I'll have more than enough range with this 100 milliwatts. This is not a long range build for me at all. I want a nimble and fast quadcopter. That's what I'm building here. And two more things, the propellers. These are the HQ props, two blade props, as you can tell. And these are, again, the same propellers as Beta FFV uses on their X-Night, their ready-to-fly version. I'm not completely sure if I'm going to be liking these. Maybe I'll try some three-bladed props as well. I'm not really sure. We'll see. Again, these are the same Beta FFV users, and we'll see how they work out. And the last part I actually don't have with me here is the receiver. I'm gonna be using an XM Plus receiver from FR Sky. Yeah, nothing special there. That'll work, especially as this is not a long range build at all. So that was a quick roundup of the parts I'll be using in this build and the why of them. And again, if you want to use this skirt as well, there's a link in the description. That's what it's for. Especially if you sometimes maybe fly in rain. Especially lately, I find myself flying in rain. So I want to protect my electronics at least a little. Not heavy rain, by the way, but yeah. So, or maybe you land in wet grass. I simply don't like having, again, the electronics out in the open, like in most ready-to-flies. Or even in a lot of the toothpick builds. And let me see, yeah, that's basically it. Next time you see this quadcopter, it'll hopefully be flying. If I run into issues in this build, I'll report back to you, and otherwise you'll see it fly next time round. For now, I want to thank you for watching. If you are left with questions, hit me up a comment down below. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye.